YouTube. This is Michigan Snowpony Renee, and I'm really late getting to the Friday questions, but last week was just horrendously busy, and it got away from me. So without further ado, let's get going here. There's not as many this week, so I'm going to read a little bit more of the letters. You can watch my hair get frizzier by the minute because it's humid today. Anyway, Melissa sent, I had a question about butchering your animals. My dream in the next 5 years or so is to move to a small piece of land that I could have animals like your pigs, chickens, and goats. I do know that I would love to raise animals for meat, but I know myself and my husband couldn't do the butchering. How do you go about finding someone to do it for you? How cost effective is it to have someone come and send your chickens to freezer camp? Okay. I actually don't have anybody come on site and do it. There is a family farm not too far from us. In fact, it's on my way to work that does chickens. They do all poultry. And I drop my chickens off before work, before going into work, and I pick them up the next day. And for $2, they butcher the chicken and give it to you in a nice little freezer bag. If you want it vacuum sealed, it's 50 cents more. If you want it cut up, it's 50 cents more. So for $3, I can get a chicken butchered, cut up, and vacuum sealed. Can't beat it with a stick. And it's a nice family, and I like to give them the business and support them. They've been there a long time, very good reputation. So that's how I do the chickens. And if you've ever plucked a chicken, you know that's worth it. Also, we don't usually have a lot to do at a time, so to set all up for chicken butchering, it's kind of, you know, you have to get in a rhythm, and a lot of people do a lot at a time to make it worthwhile. And we just usually don't have that many at a time to do, so it's worth it to me to do that. As far as the pigs, again, we have a processor that only does pigs right by us. They have a wonderful reputation. Again, it's a family farm, or it started out being. It's gotten a little bigger than that, and they do a really good job, and so we take the pigs to them. Not the greatest thing for the pigs. I mean, they probably get a little stressed from it, but it's the best I can do. My husband has no interest in processing the pigs himself. He's not a hunter, so that's the only way to do it. Go on Craigslist. You may find someone in your area that will come on site and do the slaughter and the butchering. You never know. Sometimes deer processors during the off season when they're not doing deer will do other animals. I've seen those signs. We have a guy that's local that does that as well. He doesn't have as good a reputation. So, if you live next to or near any Amish communities, a lot of times they will process animals. You might have to take them to them, though. So there's some options out there. I know it's a dilemma for a lot of homesteaders. The most ideal thing is to do your own. If my husband and I were home full-time and we didn't work full-time off-site, we would probably be a little more diligent about learning to process our own animals. But right now, time is always, we're always scrambling for time, and so we haven't made work at learning to do it. I will tell you that pigs, just to kill the pigs was $30 a piece, and the processing was on top of that. So yeah, it's not very cost effective, but I still feel good about the meat I produce and the way the pigs are raised here, as opposed to a factory farm. So it's still something I want to do and I think is worthwhile. Okay, next question. Both Angie and Tammy asked about using stock panels for staking up tomatoes and how we do it. Now, in that one video where we're bending the stock panels to shelter our pigs' pens, we used a little homemade panel bender that my brother-in-law made, and he uses that for his tomato cages. He actually makes squares out of them. We don't do that. We put up a stock panel, which is 16 feet long. We put a T-post at each end, one in the middle, and then we tie our tomato plants to that. And I use binder twine off my hay bales, which disintegrates. It's not plastic, it's sisal or whatever. It disintegrates after a year. You can also use twine, just plain old like macrame twine, anything that's gonna decompose after a year. You can also, if you're diligent enough, weave your tomatoes through the stock panel as they grow. I've done that before. That works pretty well. 1 year we put two stock panels about, I don't know, less than a foot apart and planted the tomatoes in between. And that worked okay, but we decided for the effort of putting up two stock panels versus one, it didn't work any better than just having one stock panel. So that's how we do it. Very simple. Okay, Tammy also asks,
Can you tell us more on your dislikes on canning items? Things you did and would not do again, and the ones you loved. You mentioned you did not like ham canned, I think. Actually, I love to can ham. What I can't figure out is all the different things that makes it turn out differently. In other words, it seems like a very inconsistent thing to can, and I can't quite figure out what it is that makes it different. So, but I love to have canned ham on hand. Things that I liked things that didn't turn out. Well, the first thing that comes to mind is I attempted to make zucchini pickles a couple years ago. And my family's not real big on pickles anyway, but I was trying to use up zucchini. And yeah, I wouldn't do that again. I didn't like them. Nobody liked them, so that was a waste of time. Other than that, I can't think of too many failures that I had that didn't turn out or couldn't be used for something. So, maybe I'm not adventurous enough. Oh, let's see. Christine asked, question of the day, mushy or peeling of hard-boiled eggs? I know it's not a frozen egg issue, and I think she means where it gets cold. Yeah, sometimes our eggs will freeze in the hen house. Only some of my hard-boiled eggs come out mushy or peel in layers, and others come out great. I have been giving the chickens oyster shells, scraps, fruit, greens, and even fresh grass now and then. I have tried to put vinegar in the boiling water, also letting the eggs come to room temp before boiling. Help, this is driving me crazy. And interestingly enough, Ed from Georgia sent in this tip right after she asked that. So I'm going to read what he said. I'm writing because you mentioned in one of your videos, as did Bev Wolf, the Mrs. Wolfie, that chicken eggs need to be aged before boiling because they are hard to peel otherwise. That is true, but there is a solution that doesn't require... Turning the page. Aging the eggs. And sometimes you just need to boil that egg without the weight. I put quite a bit of salt in the water, 2 tablespoons, and it has always worked for me. The shells just slide off like a 2-week-old egg. Well, Ed, that's good to know. I have tried putting salt in the water, but probably not that much. However, I haven't had the same results, so maybe I'm not adding enough salt. Maybe it's the procedure. I know I bring my eggs to a boil, then I put a lid on the pot and set them off the burner for 10 minutes. That's how I do hard-boiled eggs. So maybe it's a procedural thing with the salt. I don't know. But there you go, Tammy. Try putting at least 2 tablespoons of salt in the water and see if that doesn't give you better peeling eggs. As to why some are mushy, I don't know. That is an odd one. I don't know. Is it maybe if you could try to determine by eggshell color if it's the same eggs every time, because maybe it's a chicken thing. I don't know. Okay, GGB wrote, hi, chica. Hola, hi, chica. Question for you. Knowing what you know now, if you were about to buy a pressure canner, which one would you get? I know you said to get one with a higher capacity. Anything else to look for? That's an easy one. I'm sure my neighbors think I'm out here taking selfies all the time. Anyway, I would definitely buy an all-American canner again. That's what I have, and they, in my mind, are the best. They're made in Wisconsin, and they have a metal-to-metal seal. There's no rubber gasket to wear out and have to be replaced. And if you take care of them, they will last. Your granddaughters could be using them. They also have a gauge, a pressure gauge, so you know how many pounds of pressure are in your canner. I really haven't figured out how people can that don't have a gauge. How do you know what your pressure is? I know everybody uses those, like the Prestos and that, but I don't know how you do it. So I definitely go with an All-American again, and I would get a bigger model, like I've said. I wrote down, I have the 915 model, and that holds 9 pints and 7 quarts, and I would definitely get the 921 or the 925, and that is like what I call the double-decker. You can get 2 layers of pints in there, so they hold, I didn't write that down. Well, anyway, so it probably holds 18 pints, and if you can fit it under your cabinet, or if you have a microwave above your stove or whatever, if you have the room, go to the one that holds 2 layers of quarts, because you're going to use the same time and just you know, have that much more capacity, so you're going to be able to can faster and more efficiently, so, and less electricity or gas use. So I would definitely buy the biggest canner I can afford and that will fit on my stove, and I would definitely go with an All-American. Okay, finally, my paper blew away. Let me go get it. This is from Donna, a fellow Michigander. Hi, Renee. Two questions. Hobbies. What kind do you do other than knit? Well, before children, I did quite a bit. I used to do crafts of all kinds. I used to make jewelry, and I liked silk ribbon embroidery, and I'm trying to think what else. Oh, and the horses. The horses were my life. I was at one time, I was on a national board for a breed organization. I was on the Michigan Horse Council Trails Committee. I started a countywide riding club, and I used to volunteer for a therapeutic riding center. So the horses were my life. And then my kids came along, and that's okay. I switched gears, and I just don't have time. I do not have time for hobbies, and I'm getting back into riding now that my daughter's of an age and is horse crazy, and she wants me to ride with her. So I'm trying to get back to that. We're going to do that today, in fact. And I only knit in the winter because that's an indoor activity, and I have so much going on outside that I don't have time to do it, and I don't want that hot thing on my lap in the summer. So, you know, I figure I'll have time to do all those crafts again when I'm old and in the rocking chair, but right now, I'm busy. So I'm kind of boring that way, I guess. I don't know. And the other question, my husband got me a cider press for Christmas this year. That's so cool. I would love one of those. Lucky me. Yes, lucky you. Other than freezing it, can I can it? Yes, you can can cider. It's high acid. It's a fruit. So you're going to can it in a water bath. And I looked that up because I was curious. We don't have a cider press, but I wondered that last year, in fact. And I think it's like 5 minutes for pints and 10 minutes for quarts in a water bath canner. And you can have canned cider. And you know, if it doesn't work, you have vinegar or hard cider. looking forward to the Homestead Honey Hour this week. Remember, that's Thursday night, tomorrow night. I bought the book you gave away, 5 Acres in a Dream. Been a good read, and I find I have a lot in common with Lee. Okay, well, that's terrific. And there's my little plug for tomorrow night's show on the end of here. I want to give you one other tip. Some of you, I get a lot of questions that want to know if I've done something or if I have a video on something. And I want to show you how to do a search on any channel. And if I've included this in a previous video, excuse me, I'm getting old. But not everybody watches every one of my videos, so it's okay if it makes it into a couple of these. But this is how to find whether or not somebody has done a video on something that you're interested in. I use this a lot on Noreen's channel when I want to see if she's done her recipe. So here's how to do it. And until next time, hopefully I'll be on the ball this next week. Bye, everybody. Okay, if you are wondering if a channel that you subscribe to has done a video on something, a really easy way to check is to go to the channel homepage. This happens to be mine. And right over here under the name, you're going to see this little symbol. It's a magnifying glass. And if you click on it, it says search channel. And all you have to do is put in what you're looking for, and it'll bring up any videos the person's done that has to do with that topic. And usually very easily you can see then if they've done something that, you know, you're looking for. As an example, I just typed in stock panels. So I'm going to enter. And now it takes you to all the videos I've put up that either mention stock panels in the subject line or show stock panels, has to do with stock panels. Why my sun oven is up there, I don't know. But it's not a perfect system, but you probably will find what you're looking for, at least some of the videos that brings up. But there you go.